Hey guys, what's going on? This is Pants R Dragon, and today I want to be doing a little guide on Blitzcrank, one of my favorite champions for support, and I just want to show you guys a lot of tricks and tips with him, as I feel he's a really tricky champion, especially, you know, his key mechanic, the pull, that definitely has a lot of skill involved with it. And to give you guys some background information about me with Blitzcrank, first off, he was the first champion I ever bought with 6,300 IP. Okay, so saying that doesn't actually mean anything, but I just want to say it because it was kind of cool. Well, somewhat cool. And second off, I have 100% win rate with him as of season 6, but it's not really saying a lot since it is only 4 wins. But hey, at least the KDA is high, so that gives me some credibility. But I feel that if I can play him at a challenger level, I think I'm a pretty good Blitzcrank. I think. Anyways, with all that being said, let's get started. Actually, this was the original thumbnail, but it's kind of inappropriate. But anyways, let's get started with this guide. So first off, this guide is definitely going to be oriented around the tricks and tips, as that's going to be the really crucial part of this guide. But the masteries and rune and all that stuff is kind of crucial and a bit different from what you regularly see from Blitzcrank players. It's a more bursty style for sure, and relies on a player being good at getting hooks. Now for masteries, I go 12-18-0. As you can see, I'm going a very damage build because when I do land those hooks, I'm going for a kill, not some bitch ass harass. So you know, all in or nothing. If you're playing Blitzcrank, you're playing a kill lane, not a passive lane. You'll be wondering, why don't you go Executioner? The reason is because that missing mana mastery is actually really good, as it's like 3/4 of a chalice's passive. Plus, when I hook people, they're usually at 100% hit point, and my burst comes immediately, not when they're below 50%. Next up is going to be runes. So we take hybrid pen, reds, and quints, and then for yellows we take health, and then for blues we take mana. You know, the complement that mastery we just took, plus it synergizes with our passive. So the reason I take hybrid pen is because we kind of do both damages of physical and magical. It's actually heavily sided to magical. But yeah, some people take like physical damage quints, but the way I see it, since we do more magic damage than physical, I feel that having hybrid pen is the best choice here. And the reason I don't take armor yellows is because if my hook is down, then I'm not going to trade, or take any harass for that matter. And finally, the item build. So it's going to be a relic shield start. We're just going for that little tanky build, and then I go Eye of Equinox because we aren't really building health, so Face of the Mountain won't be giving a lot of health when we use the active, and then it's a support build right after that. Now we got some situational items like the Frost Glove. I would only get that if I were ahead. Actually, most items here are just fun items, except for Randuin's. You might want to get that on top of Frozen Heart if they have a lot of physical damage. But that's my build for Blitzcrank. Now finally we can move on to the tips and tricks. And there's going to be a lot of them, so hopefully this will definitely help your Blitzcrank out. So Blitzcrank is all about prediction. You shoot your hook based on where you think the enemy is going to be in like 0.5 to 1 second. It also goes the other way, where if you're against a Blitzcrank, then you're going to try and predict where he's going to shoot that hook. Now, the first tip, the Q hitbox is kinda broken. It's actually much bigger than the animation provides. It's somewhat indicated by your Q's cast reticle, so remember this when you're landing your hooks. Next up is gonna be a trick, and this one, basically when a minion is about to die, that's when you shoot your hook. They won't expect it because they think that minion that's right there is blocking them, and so when it dies, it kinda gives them a false sense of security, and indirectly, if they know you can do this, you can actually zone them a lot more, and they'll be pretty scared whenever their own minion is about to die. The way to do this, to be honest, is if you know your AD carry is about to kill a minion, that's when you can grab. So let's slow down this clip, and as you can see, I see the arrow attack, so that's my pivotal point, and I land the grab. Oh, and don't worry, we win the trade. See? Sometimes it's okay to pull the tanks if they don't have their E. Another tip with this is, you know, if you have your ultimate and there's a minion, you can just ult and kill the minion and then grab. Rarely I'll ever do this, as it's kind of risky since you do not have your ultimate if you miss the hook. Sadly, this is the only clip I've ever done it and failing to do so. Next tip, get as close to someone before grabbing. You don't want to go for those max range hooks, they're so easy to dodge. I mean, if a target is closer, you're probably going to have more accuracy. And also, while you're trying to run up to the enemy that you're trying to pick and getting as close as you can, they might, you know, blow a few summoners or a dash or something to avoid the initial grab or fist. You know, like I said earlier, they're trying to protect whenever you're going to use your Q, so you might never know, they might just panic flash or something. But yeah, that's going to be my next tip. Usually you want to hold on to your grab until they juke. You see, a character like Vayne, she has her tumble, so she's gonna see when the rocket grab is coming, and then she can tumble away from it. You can see in this scenario, I want to power fist her ass before using my Q to get that ensured hook, as if I do miss my hook, that means she can actually go onto me and give me some damage. And yeah, what you should do is you should hold on to your grab on someone who has a dash. Once they use it, they're very vulnerable. But if they use it to dodge your grab, they can punish you easy peasy lemon squeezy. Now in teamfights, try and snipe the squishies with your grab. So usually when you get initiated on, your team gets initiated on, you don't always have to use your grab immediately. You can actually save it until you get an insured hit on someone. So potentially you can offer so much zoning to a teamfight if say you're in a really good position. And yeah, just try and get a little flank and maybe you'll pull someone to your team. Now for my next tip, try and grab someone when they're doing an animation. So an animation could be something like an auto attack or someone casting a spell, but basically it opens a window of opportunity for you to grab them when they're a little vulnerable. See how in this clip I'm using again, she's just using an auto attack and is also pretty focused on killing the Darius, so I see that and I grab that pussy. Next one is going to be a combo. This is a combo that guarantees your CC and the grab. And the combo is just a power fist flash, and then you grab them when they're about to land on the ground. But you want to walk away a little bit, so you can kind of pull them closer to your team. Now remember when I said Blitzcrank is all about prediction? So if an enemy has an escape, like flash or a dash or something like that, you have to be one step ahead of him and grab where you think he's going to use it at. Especially champions who have dashes, it's going to be a little bit tricky to land the grab on them unless they don't have it up. So yeah, always got to be one step ahead of them every time. Now, in the laning phase, as long as you have your grab, you have zoning potential. If you don't have it, well, you're somewhat vulnerable since your Q is very powerful, and the enemy knows that's down, well, they can abuse that and maybe potentially zone you, go on you, engage on you, make a play. I don't know. Don't worry about this clip, I think we're just super fed. But yeah, sometimes it might be better to hold onto your Q, especially if you don't think you're gonna land it. Next up is gonna be a trick, and I call it the JFK grab. Originally, it was called the Just Kidding grab, but that's super lame, and we don't like that shit. So basically what this JFK grab is you pretend you're gonna grab someone by having similar movements when you're about to grab someone, and then all of a sudden you grab another person. So you know, running up to someone, they might think you're trying to be a predator for them, but then you know, you just pull a JFK on them and then you grab someone else. Next tip, crowd-controlled people are easy targets. So if someone is CC'd, slowed, stunned, anything, you should always have a guaranteed hook on someone. There's no excuse for missing that unless, you know, they flash or your hand slipped or something, I don't know. You should always be able to pull someone who is stunned. So in my head, usually, to get more accuracy, I will wait until my team does some sort of CC, and that way, instead of going for a 50-50 grab, I have a guaranteed grab. The next tip with Blitzcrank, concentration is key. If you aren't in the zone with Blitzcrank, you're gonna miss a few pulls. And usually when I'm concentrating Blitzcrank, I will look at how my enemies are moving and kind of predict where they're gonna be next. So usually when I'm like chilled out or not really trying, my eyes are like this, but when I'm focusing on trying to hit a hook on someone, my eyes are like this. So yeah, having a lot of concentration with Blitzcrank is definitely key to having success with him. Now one general rule of playing Blitzcrank is you don't want to pull tanks into your team, but you can pull them away if they are going onto your AD carries. So yeah, this is a really good way to peel for your AD carries. You want to pull the tanks away, not pull them in. Next up is going to be another trick, it's going to be called between the legs. So, the hitbox may be broken, but at least minions' hitboxes are really small. So if you ever see a situation like this, you may be able to grab someone between the legs. It's a very rare situation, but it can be done. So yeah, as you can see throughout this video, there's a lot of tricky stuff you can do in the laning phase. And finally, we have a general tip for our last tip. So with Blitzcrank, you want to roam a lot to mid with this champion. If you can't land the hooks in the laning phase, or the lane is pushing into your tower, that's your cue to roam mid. And Blitzcrank is a champion who offers a lot of CC, so it is pretty easy for this champion to get some kills while roaming. So yeah, look for opportunities where you can roam mid or somewhere and try and get a kill. Here's a live gameplay example of roaming.
I should have gotten this, man.
Feels good, man. By the way, Spence, you just sit at tower, I'm going top. Peace out. Now, freeze for a second. Why am I roaming right now? It's because our lane is going to be pushed into our tower. Therefore, Kog'Maw can get free farm. Now, hopefully, this tip on roaming helped you on roaming. And you are a better player. Yeah. Go you. You're the best. And yeah, that is it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it a lot, as Blitzcrank is one of my favorite champions to play when I am playing the support role because he's just so fun, plus he's really good too. And so that kind of leads up to a question where I want to ask you guys, what is your favorite pick in an off role? Yep, mine would definitely be Blitzcrank because I think he's super fun. In another video, I asked you guys, what is your go-to champion for the jungle? And here are some of my favorite comments. So yeah, make sure to comment below on what is your favorite champion to use on an off role, and maybe you might just be featured in another video. Anyways, if you did like this video, make sure to leave a like, and if you want to see future videos like this, make sure to subscribe. Anyways, I am Pantsart Dragon, and I'll see you guys next time.
never going out of style. Ooh, pretty baby, this world might have gone crazy. The way you save me, who could blame me when I just wanna make you smile? I wanna do you like Michael. I wanna kiss you like Prince. Let's get it all like Marvin, yeah, like
Oh my god. Fucking Blitzcrank mid. That guy's so tilted. He's like, Blitzcrank mid again? What the fuck?
Fucking call missing.
It's so funny. I'm always here.